Thank you, Wendy. I want to welcome everyone to this webinar on design thinking and project management. And I'm going to give you a little bit of an introduction here. As we all know, the pace of change and disruption in the business environment demands that we as project leaders acquire and grow in our skills. Indeed, we need new tools and models in order to operate in a more flexible, discovery-generated world. We need to be successful, and we need to look past the rigor and the discipline of managing projects as we have in the past. As project leaders, we should embrace agility, collaboration, thinking about customers first, innovation, and even adaptive leadership. As I'm sure many of you have heard the phrase, evolve or be disrupted, this is truly our situation for our profession right now. Design thinking has emerged as a successful methodology that organizations can use to approach problem solving, as well as delivering innovative solutions that make their customers delighted. Design thinking provides models for project leaders to become more successful in our ever-changing profession. This presentation explores the intersection between design thinking and project management, and I will be providing you a high-level overview of design thinking methods and tools. I will also use two case studies from my own work experience to show how successful design thinking can be integrated into your projects with lessons learned and unique outcomes. The intended audience of this presentation are project managers, scrum masters, business analysts, project owners, and other associated project management professionals. Lastly, there are going to be two hands-on exercises that I'll be conducting during this webinar. You will need both a writing utensil and some blank sheets of paper to participate. I recommend that you take the time now to find a writing utensil and the paper. So let us begin. As I'm showing here, the objectives of today's webinar include being able to describe the benefits of incorporating design methodologies on projects for increased customer alignment and business impact. And second, being able to identify and apply design thinking techniques for improving benefits realization on your projects. As I mentioned, we're going to be doing a couple of exercises. Our first exercise is called speed sketching. And the first lesson that I want you to learn today is being visual is an important part of the design and allows for a more precise communication. Sketching is a very important tool for designers. Not only does it allow to be able to have visual records of existing designs, but allows people to get ideas out of their heads and down onto paper. Sketching is a type of visual brainstorming. And the primary function of a sketch should be informative and communicative. All right, to participate in this exercise, you'll need a blank sheet of paper. Now take that paper and draw lines on it as shown on this slide. You will want to divide up the sheet of paper into the six sections as shown. You will be given 6 seconds to draw each of the individual words on the following slides. Let us get started. The first word will be home. Coffee. Mouse. Sun. computer. And now the last word, bread. Okay, stop. Let's take a moment to review what you have sketched or drawn. As you may have noticed, these are very common words, but they could have different meanings depending on the situation. I've conducted this speed sketching exercise several times with live audiences, and there appears to be some common patterns where the different pictures are sketched in different ways for these words. So who here in the audience drew an animal for the word mouse? Who drew a computer mouse for the word mouse? For the word computer, who drew a desktop versus a laptop? And for coffee, was it steaming hot or was it coffee in a cup? And lastly, when you were drawing your home, did it include a chimney or was it without chimney? As you can see, you could mean different things for these different words. There could be different concepts behind these. And when I do these with live audiences, there tends to be about a 2/3 to 1/3 difference with the folks on the left column versus the right column. Again, the message I want to bring here is that being visual is important to the design. It doesn't mean that you always have to draw things perfectly. It's just an added form of communication that allows more precise sharing of ideas. Getting a concept or an idea down on paper or on the whiteboard helps to clarify the understanding before your teammates. And as I'm showing here is a couple examples on this slide that are visual and physical artifacts that my own teams have used. As you can see, we have one room at the bottom right that's full of a lot of different stickies and pieces of paper. This was collected after doing some research on our users. The two top drawings are just a physical manifestation of how data flows or a workflow. And then the left-hand side is just an example of how we've been able to do user surveys with users of our system and have had them generate different responses to questions that we have. So let's get to the center of everything. What is design thinking? I'm now going to provide you a high-level overview of design thinking and then cover some of the benefits of incorporating design on projects. Is design thinking another business fad that's being pushed and peddled by design gurus and consultants? Or could it be a strategic differentiator in the rapidly changing business environment that we operate in? One thing that I can tell you what design thinking is not, it is not a workshop. Joni Saylor from IBM Design shared this slide at the Design Thinking Conference back in April 2018. I really like this picture. I think it's very appropriate. I think the point that she's trying to get across here and that what I want you to be able to take home is companies often think that design thinking can be implemented in a single day or a two-day workshop. That is not design thinking, nor is it integrating design thinking into your project. In the following slides, I'll be showing you how a workshop is not a full manifestation of design thinking. Here, I'm showing how academics view design thinking. What I'm showing is the Hassi-Lasko framework. They're professionals from Finland who have one of the most comprehensive frameworks. They've done a lot of study in this space. And they've pointed out that there's some common elements on design thinking. And these are grouped into practices, cognitive approaches, and mindsets. As project